Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, this is the World of Wayne. We now got pack 3 of the Agora Models release of build, the Mitsubishi A6M Zero Fighter. Now if you remember in pack 1 and 2, we basically finished the whole front end of the plane, the whole propeller and engine system, and that looked like this. Some people were concerned that we did all of this and then covered it with the cover here, but as you can see, this is magnetic, so these come off, so you can actually see all the gumps and all the stuff inside there, and obviously it works absolutely perfectly. But I'm going to put that to one side, because today we're going to start working on the machine guns and the cockpit area. Now if you want to get this all the way from pack one, all you have to do is just follow the link down here to Agora Models website and you'll be able to get that all for yourself. Over on their website as well, you can see such things as the Bismarck, the Terminator, the Super Snake, the Cobra, the soon to come Leopard tank. I mean, there's a plethora of things coming there, but once again, just go over to the Agora Models website and you'll be able to get this all the way from pack one. But it may look like a small box, don't let that deceive you, there's loads to do in this one. So without further ado, let's get cracking. So we're going to start with pack 16. Now this basically covers this pack 16 to pack 26. So quite a few things in there, and we're going to start with the machine guns first. Now each pack contains a different machine gun, so I've just opened the left one now, but we're going to start on the right one here, so I'll get this all out. So with the right one, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to take the casing and the barrel here, and that little notch that we've got just there is going to fit right on the end into that section like that. It's not glued into place. Now I just need to put that down gently while I get the LED light out. We need to actually bend this light at right angles. Now you can use needle nose pliers for that. I've got some really thin pliers here, so I'm going to do it with those and just bend it at a 90 degree angle like that. So when we've got that, we just want to put that inside this section just there of the barrel. And then this is where we're going to need some glue, because we're going to close those sections off with the other side of this case here. And we have got a lug just at the back which needs glue on it. So I put glue all around this, just like that. And then we're going to pinch all of these together, making sure that the wire's not pinched, and push this down into position, just like that. The only thing we have to do then is glue this handle on to the side that's actually got a little tiny indent there for this to go. You've got a lug to line up at the bottom, one at the top, hold it for a second, and that is one complete machine gun. Got to do the same thing to the left hand side. So I should be a dab hand at this for the left side, so I'll put the barrel in first, making sure that notch fits in that section there. Bend down the LED, so it's a very tight right angle there. You can use tweezers, I found it easier to actually use my hands, but lie that in where it's going to go, just there. Put some glue into this recess on this side. Put in, make sure I've got a lot of glue in there. Put the top on to pinch all that together like that. There we go. And then once again, just checking what side I need to put this on. Put the handle on this section here. That's the handle on. That's another machine gun done. So as you can see, two machine guns done. That's all there is to do in that stage. Now in stage 17, we're going to be working on engine mounts and sights. So I'll get all these out. And it's the engine mount that we're going to be working on first. Lots of little tiny pieces in this one. And I'm just laying this out where it's going to go. So we need this ring here and then we need these two sides here. Now they normally tell you what side they're going to go on. I can't see a right or left, but just laying them out like they are in the picture, they're going to go on this way. So when these are on, if I do a dry fit for you, they're going to look like that, facing outwards that way. I'll do the same just on this side here, like that. So that's how that's going to look. So when you're happy with that, we can glue these into place. One, two. That's one side. And one, two. And that's the other side. Try to let it fall into place of where it wants to fit itself, and that way you can ensure that it's going to fit absolutely perfect and flat in there. Now we're going to be putting this V-shaped section in the bottom. We've got some little notches or little lugs just on each side of here, which are going to go into some little holes that we can see on each side of these here and here. I think this is going to be a case having to wear my glasses for this one. So I'll put some glue into the center hole there, and then I'll put some glue just onto the side where these are going to fit in. Excellent. And then I'm going to put this section in here, and it should sit perfectly enough to enable me to push these ends in, one this side, and do the same on the other side just there. And that has fit absolutely perfectly in there. Now we can put that to one side and leave that to dry, because we're going to work on the sights now. Now this is what the sight looks like. Look at the detail in that. That is amazing. That's going to be going on this mount here. And we've got a peg just at the bottom there, which is just going to go into the hole that we can see just there. So what I'm going to do, put some glue just onto that hole there. Make sure we put it in the right way. And that's going to go in here. I'm going to push it down. And when that's in, that looks just like that. And that's all there is to do in that stage. Now it is worth noticing that in the last stage there, we do have these screws. They've been left over. We need to keep these safe. But stage 18, we're going to start the cockpit. Now let me just show you this cockpit on the top camera. All metal. And look at the detail in that. It's all been coloured for us already with the lovely silver or steel bar there. And that's what it looks like on the close-up. And the first thing we're going to do is put a window in. The window looks like that. We're going to be gluing that into this point like that. Now if we put super glue on that, there's a chance you're going to frost that up, so I'm not going to do that. Now it will take a while to dry, but I am going to use a little bit of micro crystal clear around the edges here. Now that will keep this in place, but it's not going to have any danger of frosting that up with super glue. Now the glue that I use, lots of people ask me about it, doesn't really go white on my one like normal super glues will. Just add that on my finger there. But I don't want to take that risk. So I'm making sure I've put a thin line around this edge here, just like that. Put the lid back on. Once again, what I'm using here is just called a micro crystal clear. You can actually make windows with this, but it doesn't leave a white residue. It actually dries perfectly clear. And then we're going to put the window in, just like that, so it'll be flat on this side, but on this side here it's going to be where it needs to be. Now as you see, you've got the white edges around there, but that will dry perfectly clear. So now we can turn this over now, because we're going to start putting some details on this section here. And the first detail we've got is this little bit of pipe work here. That's going to go into the two holes just at the top there. So I've got my super glue back now. I'm going to drop those in those holes. One and two. And as you can see on the back of this, we have got two little lugs. Line them up, put that into place. That's one in. I think I'm going to use my tweezers for this. And when that's in, that should look like that. Now the next detail looks like that. And it wants to go in this way with the sections here pointing down. It's actually going to go in these two holes here. They are different size lugs, so it's pretty easy to see which way round it's actually going to go. But I'm going to put some glue just into these here. And then gently push this into place. Just like that. Now that was the hydraulic pump that I just put in there. The next thing we're going to do is put in a couple of little handles. So we've got a hole just down the bottom there. I'm going to put this in because it's a very tiny part with my tweezers in here and make sure it's straight. Now I thought there was a second one. There isn't. This is a spare at the moment. We only have to put one handle in, so I'll keep that safely to one side. But with everything we've got there, that's all there is to do in that stage. Once again, we are left with some screws here. So I'm going to keep that safely to one side as well. Now, issue 19, we're continuing with the cockpit assembly here. Once again, look at all of these parts. These are excellent. So we've got the metal part looking like that. A little bulkhead there. This part's plastic. So there is a mixture between metal and plastic here. And once again, another bag of screws. Not quite sure what we're doing with those yet. So we want to take this bulkhead of the cockpit and we want to bring over the section which has got the sights on that we worked on last time. And that's actually going to go into this section just at the top there. So it's going to fit in just like that. Now we need to fix that in with a screw that came in part 17. Now that's the ones that look like that with little points on the end of them. We only need one of these. So once again, I'll line that up and we'll screw that in. Make sure it's nice and tight and that's in place like that. We can put that down because we're going to take this section now and guess what we're going to be mounting to this. You've got it. We've got the machine guns. Now when we put these machine guns in, the handles that we put on here need to be on the inside, so they're going to sit in kind of like that on that one. So as you can see, this handle is pointing on the inside here. So with the handles on the inside, then we're going to push these in just like this. And I think it's probably best if I get one in first to show you how it fits, because when you push this in, it's not going to need glue, so it should sit in nice and flat like that. Do the same on the other side here. Put the wire in first, line it up with the back section, and then push that down. Make sure they're sitting flat in there. And there we go. That's both of those in. And just for now, leave the wires hanging down the bottom. But that's all there is to do in that stage. Now in stage 20, we've got some electrics to work on here. Lots of electrics actually. So the first thing I do is push that to one side. I'm going to take the electrics, just unravel it. And we're going to be putting this at the base of where we've just installed the machine guns here. Now when we put this on, we want to put this underneath the wires there. It's going to fit on those sections there. So the wire that's coming from this will go down this trunk in the middle there. So what I'm going to do is line that up first, so that all of these wires here that we've got coming out the bottom go through there. It's a little bit tricky. You've got a black set of wires and a red set of wires. I'm going to use a flathead screwdriver to just push that into the cavity there. So that should look like that. Lovely wire tidy there. But we're going to screw this in using two screws that actually come in this stage. So I've got them here. That's the first one. I haven't screwed it in all the way yet. Just enough to line this up. There's the second one, and then just make that tight. And now we can put that to one side. Then we want to bring over the side of the cockpit here, because we've got some details to put in this. The first one looks just like that little bracket here. Now that's going to clip over this edge here, and the lug here is just going to go into that central hole. So it's going to sort of fit on like, oops, put it in that. Now we can fit this, but it's not to be glued. So I'm just going to clip this on the bar like that. Should hold itself in actually when it's clipped on. We've got a couple more details to put on here. We've got the fuel pump handle, which looks like that. It has got a little bend in it, and these do get glued in. So I'm going to be gluing that into the hole that we can just see there. Drop some glue just into that tiny hole there. And then put this on. It is interesting to see how this is all painted ready for us there as well. Like that. And then we've got the foot pedals here, like that. Once again, these are going to be glued in just into this section at the front here. Put some glue in there, a bit more. Like that. And then that will go in this way. Holding that for a second. So that's the foot pedals in as well. Now we want to turn this over, bring over the machine guns that we were working on. So then what we do is we turn this over, and you see I'm holding the machine gun section here because we're going to be putting this together onto that. So what we need to do is thread this cable through from this side, like that. And then once we've got that in place, we can put these together. Like that, and we're going to screw it in with two screws, and they are the screws, the black screws that came with part 18. So here's the first one. Just put that in lightly for a second, and then here's the second one in the other side, and then just make that really tight. And when that's in, that should look just like that. I can't believe how detailed this is. But with this section here as well, that's all there is to do in that stage. Now stage 21, more parts of the cockpit, so I'll get all of these out. Now in stage 21, as you can see, we've got the board for the dials here, and we've actually got the dials as well. So holding this way around, we want to make sure we put the dials in the right way. Now I'm using my magnifying glasses to help me with this. So I'm going to put it in exactly like they have in the picture. They say the larger holes go towards the inside. So now I know where they go. I'm going to put some glue just on these points inside here. One and two. And I'll put the first lot of dials in, making sure they're going in the right way. Excellent. And I'll put the second one in as well. And I'll show you exactly what that looks like. I have noticed before I put this in, I have got a tiny bit of flashing just on the side here, which I'm just going to cut off. And then I will just sand that a little bit. Excellent. Once again, I'll get this one in. So that fits flat. There we go. That, wrong way round, is all the dials in there like that. Now this whole panel here is going to be glued on top of the instrument panel here. So I'm going to, again, just do a quick dry fit on this to see how it fits. It has got some little notches to go in, but it's going to look just like that. So I'll get this glued into place. I think the best way to do this is to actually apply glue just to the underside of these sections here. One, two, M3, M4. Now that top section should glue it in. They do suggest gluing some bottom sections in as well at the bottom, but I'm happy with how that's going to sit on there. That's never going to move. But that is the dashboard. That looks brilliant, doesn't it? And that is all there is to do in that stage. Now, stage 22, we're going to start work on a little bit more of the fuselage here. So we've got some details to put on this section, which I'll just get out here. So the first detail we've got is a little box section that's just going to fit over that square just there. So I'm just putting some glue just around the edges of that. And we can just put that on. That's the first one in. The second one's just going to go underneath it. It's a larger box, this one. Put it around the side there. Plenty of glue. And then that one's going to go just in there. Hold it for a second. And there we go, we've got two on now. And the third one, they're going to make a little bit easier for us what way round it goes, because we have got a semicircular lug in there, which is going to match the hole at the bottom of this, which means it can only go in one way. And when that's in, it should look like that. And that's all there is to do in that stage. Stage 23, we've got a few more details to put on to that section. We've also got a little bit of electrics here as well. So the first detail is just going to go over the top of this silver section here. So when this is in, it's going to look like that. So I'll drop some glue in there, just into these two points here. That should be ample. Again, push that in. And there we go. That fits in perfectly. We've got some handles to put on. Now the first handle hasn't got any silver on it at all, but it's going to go into this hole just here. Put some glue inside there. It does have a semicircular lug in it though, so it'll only let you put it in one way, but that's the first handle in. We've got two more handles to put in, and they're going to go into these two holes here. Can you believe the amount of detail in this? So I'll just put glue into those holes. Now they have got semicircular lugs, which are gonna dictate where they go. So that's the first one in. The second one, which goes above it, has got a slight bend in it as well. But it can only go in one way, just like that. Now we have got this spotlight to put in here. Now that is going to go into the section under the first box that we just put in right there. And what we'll do is we're going to thread it through this hole that we can see here. And if I just place it in where it goes, there is a notch. You push it into place just like that. You don't need to glue that in. But that is all there is to do in that stage. Part 24, once again, we're working on more of the cockpit. Again, I am in awe at the amount of detail that we've got here. Now, this has already got some of the details on for us, as you can see there. But we don't actually need that section first. We're going to open these details here and just bring over the one that we've just been working on, because we've got another thing to add to this. And that looks just like this. That's just going to go into the top hole that we can see there. Once again, put some glue in here. I have to say, I thought the Spitfire was detailed when we did this on the Spitfire, but this is taking it to a completely new level. There we go, that's in. I'm telling you, the amount of detail in this is amazing. Okay, we're going to bring over this side of the cockpit now. We've got some details to put onto this one. The first one we've got is this very large disc section here. That's just going to go into these two points here and here, which will help us to line this up which way it goes. So just line up the large lug and the small one, and then push that in. We can put that to one side because we've got some little dials now just to put into this section here. I'm laughing because it's just crazy, absolutely crazy how much detail this has got. A little bit of hair on the end of my thing there, but I'm just going to make sure that I put these dials in the right way. So I've got my glasses on just to have a quick look at them. Don't want the dials to be upside down. That's what way they're going to be going in. So they're going in this way here. Push that into place so we can see them on the other side like that. And then with these sections now, that's all there is to do in that stage. Now this is the penultimate stage. We've got stage 25 with another little electric spot in there and some more details to put on that side of the cockpit. So having it this way round, we're going to be putting the emergency, what they call this, the emergency floating device cock piping in. That's just going to go into this hole just there. It is directional, so it's like a semicircular lug. That's going to go in like that. The next detail, which is the throttle and gun selector, is just going to go into the semicircular lug that we've got here. It is directional, so it can only go in one way again. Hold that into place. There we go. Then we've got a tiny seat light, which is going to go into the hole just at the top there. That's what the seat light looks like again. That's just going to go in like that. And we can put that to one side. We need to bring over this instrument panel because we've got the fuel tank switching pipe to put in. Now this has got a little angle on it. It's going to actually just go into the two holes underneath this section here. So it's going to go on this side. Again, I'll do a dry fit to show you how that looks. It's going to go in just like that. So once again, I will put some glue in the back side this time. Make sure we put this in the right way so it's actually bending forward. It can't, the lugs are like thin on one side, thick on the other. So it'll only let you put it in one way anyway. But when that's in, that should look like that. And then this whole section here, holding it this way, is going to go along this side of the cockpit. So it's going to be sitting into these points just there. So I'll put some glue just into these holes. One, two. And lastly, number three there. Line this up. One, two, three. And then push that all the way in. Making sure it's straight. There we go. That looks like that. And then once again, we've got another spotlight to put in. So it's going to go through this channel just down here. And again, it's going to be sitting into this hole that we've got there, with this coming out the back just like that. But that, show you on the top camera, looks pretty impressive, doesn't it? It's all there is to do in that stage. And now the last stage, this was a really enjoyable pack, just with the amount of detail in it. We're going to be working on the cockpit partition, and we've got some little like oxygen tanks here to glue on. So we've got one that's going to sit just on its own, and that's going to go into this hole just there. So it's this way round. Make sure you got it the right way around. So I'll push that in. That fits perfectly there. Then we've got two, which are going to go on the other side here. That's slightly different, this one, because these are actually just going to go into this hole here. They're sort of going to go part way into the doorway. So I'll put one side in and show you how that looks. Just like that. Now these two sections here are directional, so I'm just having a look at each one. If you look at the picture, it tells you what one's right and what one's left. So I've laid them out exactly as they're meant to be. The ends do drop down slightly, so that's how we can tell what side's what. Now these are the seat frames. We want to turn this over like this, and they're going to go into the top hole just here. I'll put one bit of glue in there, and I'll put the left side in first, like that. And then we do the same just on the other side here for the right one. Push that in, make sure it's sitting flat, and they all look exactly the same like that. And that is all there is to do in that stage. That's all there is to do in that pack. So if I lay these out exactly what we've done in this pack, absolutely loads, but look at the detail in some of these sections. Got this one here as well. And then finally, I don't know if I can get this in here, probably on this side. No, we've done that section as well. But that is all there is to do in that pack. How enjoyable was that? You know what, I found that quite calming compared to pack two, which was a little bit difficult. This was difficult and it was a little bit fiddly, but it was calming. It was nice putting those little details in, and I'm sure you'll agree. Let me just give you this against me for some scale there. The detail is amazing, absolutely amazing. I got a big smile on my face at the end of that one. If you want to do this for yourself, once again, I've put the link down here for the Agora Models website. You could get this all the way from pack one. But I really do hope you liked that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.